Okay, I hope you enjoyed this experiment with all these words and terms floating around. Before we go ahead, I have a book recommendation for those of you who have an affinity to linguistics and poetry. It is this little nice book, and the title is simply Crystallography. Published originally in 1994, now available in the second edition from 2003. But it is not an ordinary textbook on this subject. It's from the international recognized Canadian poet Christian Beck. And it is an experimental book which deals with the language itself. Interestingly, in his view, the language can be considered as a crystallization process. And this is emphasized, for instance, in patterns like these, made of words. Here, the two words crystal and lattice form a distinct pattern, namely a crystal lattice. Well, this was, of course, just a side note, and now we want to switch over to the systematization of the content of this course. Let's start. You will learn about the fundamental concept of the unit cell, and that this unit cell can have only seven principally different dimensions and angles between the faces. Only seven. These are called crystal systems, and the terms you see here are just the names for them. You will learn how the outer shape of crystals can be described. This is the area of morphology. Morphology is Greek and means simply study of shape. In this context, the so-called Miller indices play a role, which are a sort of orientation guide, something like a street map, but through crystals. We will address this topic too, but only shortly. The outer shape of crystals can be categorized in terms of symmetry, and this will lead us to the point groups. Point groups describe the symmetry of any macroscopic object, of finite objects. We will see what crystallographic point groups, the so-called crystal classes, are about. The space group, in turn, is only the complete description of the symmetry of a crystal, namely the outer shape plus the symmetry inside the crystal. The symmetry can be described through the existence of several symmetry elements. On these elements, corresponding operations are carried out. And you see here some of these elements. We will explain all of these symmetry elements and operations, not necessarily on crystals, but also on objects of everyday life. Next, the lattices are introduced. And we ask, for instance, what is the relationship between the mathematical construction called a lattice and our real crystal? What is represented, for instance, by such a lattice point? This will be the base or the motive. The systematics of crystal lattices was elaborated by the French physicist Auguste Bravais, who showed that there are only 14 of them, and we will see which ones. To describe solid-state matter, there are two complementing concepts. The first one makes use of the closest packing of spheres, in which other species can be located in the voids of such a packing. The second concept is based on coordination polyhedra. Here you can see such a polyhedron with the species here located in the center, which is surrounded by certain other species to build this geometrical regular form. These polyhedra are in turn connected to neighboring polyhedra to build the whole crystal, and this in a specific way. For instance, these can be edge connected or corner connected or face connected. We will have a look every now and then how these two general concepts are related to each other. And finally, we will have a look at quasicrystals. Quasicrystals were discovered by Daniel Schechtman from Israel, and for his outstanding work on this topic, he was awarded with a Nobel Prize 2 years ago. We hope we will be able to explain in which way quasicrystals are indeed crystals and in which respect they are not. So, this was a first overview of the content of our course, and now I would say, let's go!